12 months ago, I picked up a map of Chile, just out of curiosity. This map created a dream, an infectious idea that I could paddle down the west coast of Chile. Patagonia. A name that comes hand in hand with epic stories. A place marked with a solid reputation for harsh and unforgiving conditions. And one of the only places in the world where glaciers are still growing rather than receding. It seemed to me like the perfect place to have an adventure. Finally, after 26 hours of flying, a 12-hour bus ride, and 4 long hours waiting for the sun to rise in the bus station, we had finally arrived in Puerto Montt, a small industrial town where we were to collect our boats and catch a ferry down to Puerto Eden. To get to our start point at Puerto Eden, we needed to catch a ferry. It would take 3 days to get there, as Puerto Eden is one of the remotest villages in Chile and only accessible by sea.
I do get very confused with buttons. I just randomly hit things now. Right, okay, give us that long.
One hour after the English Channel, we will be making a stop that will be our only stop in Puerto Eden, which is a village here in Wellington Island. And we will leave some passengers there. Will be made the Kayaking. And where are you going to? Puerto Natales?
Si.
Yes? And how many days will you take for that?
7 days.
That's a good day. You will like it. You'll love it.
Right, this is the exciting bit. There's nobody else to sort stuff out apart from us now. That's what I'm really looking forward to. Travelling's all been a bit of an adventure, but really this is what we came out here to do. And as Erin said, once that ship sails away to get to our destination, it's completely down to us. Everything: food, camping, travelling, distance, sorting out the problems, and that's what more can you do in somewhere as remote as this.
Thanks to our friend Pillar, who had helped us with all the Spanish logistics, she had managed to persuade the Navmag ferry company to make a special stop at Puerto Eden for us. A small village consisting of brightly coloured tin shacks and a tiny settlement of very hardy fishermen.
Words were
Finally, after 3 days aboard the ferry, we stepped onto the quayside at Porto Eden.
We've packed plenty of freeze-dried food, high-calorie snack bars, and dried fruit. We can't afford to take anything that's going to go off, so everything needs to be light, high in calories, and easy to make so that we don't use too much food.
The sky's turning purple above the community centre, and I'm sitting in a circle telling my secrets to strangers. And they say I've got a problem, but I don't know that I've got one, 'cause you never know that you've got one. Someone comes along and spots one. They say it's the hardest step, but it's the first one of many. And my feet are stuck to the ground and I can't seem to take any. I could tell them I just came.
The Chilean Armada control the waters around the country. They require all vessels and craft to pass an inspection, which ensures that safety equipment and procedures are in place before anyone leaves the port.
Well, that was our inspection, and I think we passed.
We all know the words, but we just sing them out of tune.
We had finally packed our boats with 40 days worth of food and gear. Our paperwork was now complete, and the Navy captain had approved our launch.
My face down in the rubble, and everyone was drinking singles. I poured myself a double.
It's just two yellow boldies.
And now I'm sitting here with my name badge, and I'm listening to the same sad stories about their old dads, and making all of the same bad turnings at their crossroads, and drowning all this sorrow.
So after 8 months of planning, and 7 days of travelling to get to this point, we're finally on the water for the first time.
Our route would wind its way south, covering 800 kilometres, whilst also taking in some of Patagonia's remote west coast glaciers. We would then head back inland to our finish point, Porto Natales. It wasn't long before Patagonia sent us our first dose of real weather. Our boats were heavily loaded, and this had a huge effect on the way they paddled, making them hard work in any chop. We quickly learned that the weather changed continuously. It was going to become normal to experience four seasons or even more in a single day.
So it's snowing and we can't find a campsite. We can't see anything. And it's bloody freezing. He's not enjoying the snow. He's hungry and tired.
The cold really took its toll on our hands. By the end of each day, you could barely feel your fingers.
This is the best we could do, a shitty campsite. So this morning we have woken up to a blizzard. I'm quite expecting this much snow at this level, but that's what we've got.
going to be cold and hard tomorrow.
Corner, and we're just looking up this fjord here towards one of the biggest glaciers in Patagonia. It's about 40k away, and we can see in the distance now, which kind of gives you an idea of how big it is. It's about 5 kilometers wide. So we should reach there by tomorrow afternoon. That should be good. 40k's of paddling, and then back on ourselves again.
Lie and steal and cheat and beg you for my need. Make you think she needs it this time. She'll tear a hole in you, the one you can't repair. But I still love her.
Kayak Glacier is still growing in size. We were lucky to see it in such beautiful weather. The blue skies would stay with us for the next couple of days as we headed south.
Garden was blessed by the gods of me and you. We had a wish for to find ourselves some truth. Oh, what you waiting for? No, what you waiting for? We counted all our reasons, excuses that we made. We found ourselves some treasure and threw it all away. Oh, what you waiting for? For no, what you waiting for? What you waiting for? No, what you waiting for? When I dance alone and the sun's beating down, blame it on me.
It had just come to the end of our first week, and we may have already seen the ultimate perfection that Patagonia could offer us. This day of icebergs and bluebird skies, I will remember forevermore.
Lovely girl, won't you stay? Won't you stay? Stay with me. All my life I was blind. I was blind, now I see. Lovely girl, won't you stay? Won't you stay? Stay with me. All my life I was blind. I was blind, now I see. Fleet of black limousines, all tinted machines, here comes the cavalcade.
To our surprise, we bumped into our first fishing boat that afternoon. The glorious weather had allowed them to venture further from home to catch the local speciality, king crabs. They took a large detour to come over and greet us. With their friendly smiles, they chatted away in Spanish, and we chatted back in English. They kindly gifted us a king crab, which we would enjoy that evening, our first fresh food in a whole week.
He's a spiky bugger. They weren't just taking him for a ride.
His fate was...
He was going to Natalis where they put him through a machine that just slices their legs off.
And oh my, oh hey, here it comes, the big parade. Marching bands and barricades. Canvas covered.
This would be the last of our sunny weather. We had been spoiled with perfect blue skies for the past few days. Little did we know that Patagonia was about to unleash its full force upon us.
The first real time that the Patagonian weather's caught us out. Forecast force 4, northwesterly. We've got a northwesterly. We are just kind of heading around a corner into a new canal, a big wide long corner, and it just picked up. The waves were just building right across this bay. Before we know it, we're totally committed and just trying to stay with the boys, making sure the group stays together. it was carnage. It's just unbelievable to think how quickly it changes out here. And at the same time, how committed we are. We've now managed to find this tiny point that we've just dived into. There's enough of a beach just to hold out and hopefully that it'll drop. There's nowhere to camp here, so yeah, fingers crossed it's just a squall.
That was worst sea I've ever paddled in. Force, what was it, Mike?
10.
Force 20. Force 10. I was shitting myself. Erin's found herself a campsite for the evening now. This morning, sitting in my nice cosy tent, I wrote in my diary, easy day on the water's day, few hours, plod down the coast, new campsite. Oh, how wrong was I.
We had no choice but to push on. The heavy rain at that moment looked like it might be calming the wind enough to creep around the next point. Once around, we found a spot to pitch our tents. From this moment on, the weather was going to really test us.
What do you treat me?
means I'm calling on my friend. Oh, did you steal my name? Oh, you jack of all trades, you're the master of none. Oh, the race has begun. I was born a champion. I was born to jump and run.
Basically raining solid 6 days, and yeah, we're living on hope that the sun's gonna come out soon and we can just sprawl on the beach and dry everything. That'd be luxury. Well, the last 2 hours, the weather's just been crazy. It's gone from no wind, drizzle, to stonking wind, hail, snow, rain, sunshine. And it's not even 12 o'clock yet. It's amazing how this place, Patagonia, can really make you suffer at one point. And then 2 minutes later, it just rewards you with just the most amazing views. Makes you totally forget about the misery that you've just been paddling through 20 minutes ago. I suppose that's what makes it so magical out here.
Today we're on a just very wet, as opposed to swimming, which is good. It's better than it was.
Continuous wet weather meant we were using a lot of fuel and food to keep warm. We were desperately thankful when a fishing boat came into sight. Out here, it would be our only hope for getting a little bit more fuel to keep us going.
Just been over to a fishing boat just up the creek there, and asked them if we could have some petrol. All in them speaking Spanish, me speaking English. With a few pleasantries, and they were just so generous, gave us a litre of petrolo, gave us a fish, a lighter, wouldn't take any money for it. Such nice people.
When we were younger, we thought everyone was on our side. Then we grew a little and romanticized the time. I saw flowers in your hair. Cause it takes a boy to live, takes a man to pretend he was there.
Sleep from our eyes, we head to work, we catch a lift,
I'm so cold and so wet, Mike poured boiling water over my fingers, and I didn't even notice.
Last night was the first time for about an hour I saw stars. The rest of the time, grains. That's nice. But it's a little piece of heaven here on earth. Yeah, we always have a good time. Whether it's hail, rain, or it's sunshine. Yeah, we're all living that good life. Whether it's hail, rain, or it's sunshine. We reached the top, we took the fall.
Check, and we have Mars bars.
Surplus to report.
Rickles.
So this is the closest we've had to sunshine in 10 days, which is why we're smiling. Well, it's given us just a chance to try and dry out some clothes. Everything has been absolutely saturated now for over a week. Yeah, it gets tiresome, but you just get on with it. You put your wet gear on in the morning, paddle all day, and then the worst bit's actually getting in it or taking it off. It's just nice to be outside rather than hidden in a tent.
We were now deep in the heart of Patagonia. Steep, imposing mountains dominated the landscape. The scale of a place like this makes you feel so insignificant.
To the narrowest part before the tip of Estropil, probably one of the most remotest places we're going to be heading. But also this narrowing here, you can see behind me, icebergs absolutely funneling down through this narrow part with the currents. Would not like to get in their way.
The icebergs had doubled in size and numbers. We really weren't sure what we were going to find, but we knew that this close to the ice field, with such high mountains surrounding us, the possibility of this remote place being spectacular was what had driven us all this way. Found what we were looking for, a place of utter beauty, untouched by humankind, and a rare gem left in our world that still remains truly wild.